Lichens, as we know, are called as dual organisms. When I say dual organism, that means they have a symbiotic relation between algae and fungi. Now, what happens? If the algal component is predominant, we call it as phycoont. If the fungal component is high, we call it as mycobiont. Also, when the algal component succeeds the fungal component, this mechanism is known as heliotism. Now, where do these lichens grow? They can grow on dry logs. When they are growing on dry logs, they are known as corticollis. When they are growing on bare rocks, they are called as saxicollis. When they are growing on soil, they are known as pterycollis. Now coming on to classification. Classification is based on two aspects. One is the fungal component, the other is the external morphology. Under fungal components, ascolichens, basidiolichens and deuterolichens. Deuteromycetes is the group to which deuterolichens belong. Basidiomycetes to the group to which basidiolichens belong. Ascomycetes to the group where ascolichens belong. Now under ascolichens, there are two classifications. One example is Parmelia. The other is Dermatocapron. The Parmelia is an example of Gymenocarpia, where the fruiting body is disc shaped. Okay, and therefore it is also known as discolichen. The next is Dermatocapron. This is an example of Pyrenocarp. And here the fruiting body is flask shape in nature. It is also known as Pyrenolichens. Good examples of basidiolichens are Corella and Dictonema. Okay. Coming on to external morphology. Three types of lichens. Crustose, folios and fructios. Fructios is a sherb-like. It grows erect, as you can see, and hangs from a substratum. Also, there are basal mucilages which are attached to it. Acetonia and Cladonia are good examples. Folios, as you can see, are follicle. They are flat leaf-like structures. So, they are flat leaf-like structures attached to the substratum by the help of rhizoids. Good examples are Parmelia and Physicia. Crustose lichen is a lichen which is not conspicuous. It is thin. It has a flat thallus. It has a firm texture. The examples are Graphis, Hematoma and Lichenora. It also has a structure which gives you an appearance of crust, and therefore it is also known as crustose lichen. So two classifications of lichen, one based on acidomycetes, deuteromycetes and basidiomycetes, which is the components. The other based on external morphology, crustose, folios or fructios. Crustose is crust-like, folios is leaf-like, fruticos is a sherb-like cylindrical branched structure, and the examples of these are important. There could be again a match list question where you could be asked which lichens belong to which external morphology category. So be very careful, remember the examples carefully, and that's a very basic fundamental section that we have covered here. Thanks for joining in.